this is the event where we're going to share with you what we've been doing on the sculpture skills course. I'm Al Johnson, I'm curator of art for Bravo 22. So we've been making sculpture. I have to say, this is quite tricky online, and our members have been fantastic in allowing me to kind of find my way through this, because I've been teaching making sculpture for many, many years, but not online. So this has been a learning curve for us all, but we've all worked wonderfully together and it's been fantastic. We've been making sculpture. We made 4 sculptures during the course. And I have to say that everyone pretty much made all the pieces. We've been creating our own work, we've been critiquing it, we've been looking at the work of other sculptors and analysing that work. And our aims on the course were to make wonderful sculptures that went beyond our expectations. We were learning about materials and techniques, and we were enjoying working together, and I think that's a very important part of what we did. And all the work boosted confidence and self-esteem through the making process. So our participants had a wonderful outcome. So it's not all down to me to talk to you about this, because we've got some fantastic people to tell you. So first of all, we're going to have a film where Dan will tell you about the first sculpture we made, which was a clay relief. So take it away, Dan.
Hi there, everyone. I hope you're all keeping safe during these troubled times. My name is Dan Phillips, and I'm here to talk to you today about our relief sculptures. So we made our sculptures out of clay. This stuff here. Now, I'm sure you can all remember making miniature sculptures at school out of blue tack, where you'd roll it into the palm of your hand to make a sphere, or squeeze it into a cube, or make any other object out of it. Do you remember how fun and exciting it was? Well, this is far more fun to work with. Yeah. So, we take a lump of clay out of the bag. And what we'd do is we'd roll it flat to roughly 3 to 5 centimeters thick, just so we've got enough room to work with it. We're going to make a bas relief, which is a low relief in the clay. Now, you can do this either by incising into it using tools that you can buy on the internet quite cheaply, or you can use makeshift tools that you can find around the house, like a screwdriver or a pencil or anything else that you can find, really. Now, incising into it is just how it sounds. So you take chunks out of the clay, just like this. It's how I did my sculpture, taking incising into it just here. Or you can add to it. So just take the clay, press it firmly onto the surface, and then mould it into whatever shape that you're wanting to make. Now, me personally, I decided to make a relief of the Seven Sisters Cliffs. So the Seven Sisters is only a short walk away from where I live. It's a very, very special place to me. I used to run up and down them when I was younger, when I was training to join the army. And also, most of my wedding photos have the Seven Sisters in the background. So it's very, very special to me. And it's such an awe-inspiring place to visit.
Thank you.
when you finish with these, what you'd usually do is you'd mount it onto a wall and it would have one viewpoint. When we'd finished ours, what we decided to do is to make a mould out of them using alginate. Now alginate, it starts off as a powdery substance, you mix water with it, and after a few minutes it sets to a rubbery substance. So we decided to make a clay wall around our reliefs to contain the alginate, mixed it up, and then poured it very quickly onto our reliefs to take a mould. After a little while, after the alginate set, we would then remove the alginate and use the clay walled again around the alginate, because we're going to make plaster Paris positives of it. When you mix up the plaster of Paris, you want a consistency of roughly around double cream, and then we pour it into the mold. It would take roughly about 20 minutes to set, so it's pretty quick to set. However, you want to leave it about 24 hours to make sure it's fully hardened. And then once that's done, we'll then remove the alginate to reveal our plaster Paris reliefs, which we're all very, very proud of. I am looking forward to hanging this on my wall very much. For me, the whole process was really therapeutic. I absolutely loved it. I enjoyed taking the time, taking in all of the different structures of the cliffs, and absolutely loved it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dan. That was fantastic. And thank you for all the work. The work was wonderful. Well done, everyone. We wondered if we should mention alginate again, because some people had a bit of trouble with the alginate. And actually, it's possibly one of the most challenging aspects of my career so far, was doing online alginate pouring and online plaster filling. There was a moment where somebody's wall was collapsing around their clay sculpture, and I was doing this to try and stop it. But anyway, we did it and it was fantastic. So what we're going to do now is, I thought you might like to meet a few of our participants. I'm going to ask them a question about the course. So let me introduce you to the lovely Sallyanne and the lovely Adje. I'm on gallery view, so there we go. And the delightful Chris. I did say he was divine before, actually, the divine Chris. And the delectable Tim. Fantastic. So my question for you is, your start of 10 is, what did you find surprising about the course? So let's start with Sallyanne. What surprised you?
I think the biggest thing that surprised me was during wire sculpture in the end session is I discovered I've got a voice. It's given me a voice, and I no longer need to be silenced. It's helped empower me to believe in myself and believe that anything is possible. And I don't like alginate.
Fair enough. It's a voyage of discovery sculpture. You can discover yourself, but you can also discover you don't like alginate. Fantastic, thank you. What about Adje? What did you enjoy? What surprised you?
What surprised me was the people we were working with, brilliant group of people, all walks of life, fantastic people. And the clay, I was surprised how easy it was to get hold of doing the clay and the clay models. But like, I don't like alginate. Alginate's not my thing.
I might pop the alginate on another course.
Yeah, need a course, just an alginate.
Yeah, or an alginate, we'd do an alginate course. That would, yeah. Nobody would
don't
come.
Don't invite me.
Yes. Nobody turn up. Chris, what surprised you?
Well, I've done a couple of Zoom courses before and it's always a bit hit and miss. But this time, I've got to be honest here, it was so well organised. It really is quite incredible. Everything happened on time. It just was like a well-oiled machine. I mean, again, teaching online, nobody's done it before, but you were doing a marvellous job, Al. Brilliant. But the backup was fantastic. But for those of you who don't know, alginate is the stuff a dentist will stick in your mouth to mould your teeth. So there you are. So we've been making sculptures where we could have made false teeth from it.
We could. I'll slip you a tenner later for that nice that nice recommendation. But actually, I'm not going to because of the alginate reference. Tim, what surprised you?
Well, I'm not going to mention alginate.
Oh, good.
What surprised me? Well, I'm actually more me from the theatre side, and this is the first time I started on the acting, art side, which I found very interesting. And I'm normally a woodworker. My part is wood. My art is wood. And I found different things we've made out of wire, clay, alginate, and various other things that put together to make art pieces. But it really made me think that, yeah, wood is definitely my niche place to go, and I'll always be that side. But I've learned some fantastic skills on the course, especially constructing sculptures, and that's what I want to do from wood, create a sculpture. So it doesn't matter what you're working in, you can all build a sculpture, and it's always art. So no, I've thoroughly enjoyed it, and I'll learn a hell of a lot from it. So thank you.
Thank you very much. That was lovely answers. Thank you so much. Brilliant. Okay, so we're going to go on to our second sculpture now. In the second sculpture, we tackled making figures, and we were using new materials, wire, armature wire, which is a kind of bendy aluminium wire, and a plaster bandage. And we made two figure sculptures. The first was a wire and plaster bandage one. The second one had a sort of extra element, and people kind of gave their second figure a kind of story. So to tell us more about that, we've got the wonderful Paw and the lovely Christine. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Paul. I'm going to tell you about the wire figures we made on our sculpture skills course. We made wire figures using aluminium armature wire, which is a really flexible wire. We thought about proportion, the proportion of the head to the body. Length of the head fits 7 to 7.5 times into the body. We also looked at joints, how the body flexes and moves. We made proportioned figures using a wire skeleton. Then we fleshed out our figures using small sections of mod rock, a bandage soaked in plaster used for treating broken limbs.
Once we have started, we make the mod rock wet, squeeze it, make it into balls, and start adding it to the sculpture. We keep on adding until we get a resemblance of a body, and then we start building it out to make the body the right size for your own features. You can add extras, you paint it. It was great fun. I think everybody enjoyed doing the sculptures of themselves, and I really did enjoy finishing it, painting it, and making it look a lot like me.
We were asked to make a second figure and not to use plaster bandage. My second figure, I called her COVID 2020. It means hands and feet tied together. The curled hair is to represent everyone that I have heard saying, I wish the hairdressers were open. Everyone excelled all different perspectives on Al's tuition.
Fantastic. Weren't they good? I loved the extra elements that people added. It was so interesting. Thank you so much to Paul and Christine for presenting that. So we had by this time made a clay relief and we'd worked on figures. So the next project was assemblage, which in sculpture, a lot of contemporary sculpture is assemblage. It's a constructed sculpture. Sculptures can be modelled or carved, but lots of work nowadays is assembled. So we were commissioned, or I commissioned the participants, to find objects that could be repurposed around the house. And these were used for constructing a sculpture. And sometimes they were combined with made objects, so found objects and made objects. And here is Michelle and Dave to tell you more about it.
Hi, my name's Michelle and I'm going to tell you about the assemblage sculpture we made on the sculpture skills course. We did a word association game to work out ideas for the sculpture. It had to be big or small that crossed our minds. At the time I was doing a 10-day breathing class, which has helped with my anxiety, and I decided that I would try and do a sculpture of a pair of lungs. I looked for some material. At the time I was at my parents in Worthing and they had some chicken wire in the garden, so I thought I would use that for the outside of the lungs. And for the inside I decided I would either use wire or a piece of wood. I went for a walk with my dogs to try and find something that would be appropriate. Couldn't find anything, went into my garden and an angelica plant that had been in my garden for a year fell over in front of me, so I decided to use that. So the sculpture is about remembering to breathe and how important it is for us to be out in nature.
I planned my sculpture around the circumstances that caused my depression 18 years ago. So the basic idea was to illustrate my being stretched and pulled in all directions by obligations and responsibilities which I thought were beyond my control. So my sculpture is of a spring being stretched between two posts and pulled in other directions by cords. All the components are found except the spring, which I made from wire. We had to collect together objects that could be combined. The sculpture could be entirely found objects like bottles, circuit boards, feathers, book illustrations, etc., or it could be a combination of found and constructed objects.
Well, they're fantastic. We at the beginning we thought we're thinking about how to make a sculpture which is based on an open theme, and what I asked people to do was to come up with something that had happened to them in the last few days and to make a sculpture about that. So that was the result of that that process. Fantastic, thank you, well done everyone, and thanks to Michelle and Dave for telling us about that. So now we're going to meet a few more of our participants. So let's meet the marvellous Mick.
Hello, everybody.
And the delightful Debra. And I can't think of something rhyming with Julian. So the lovely Julian. And the superb Sarah. Thank you. So my question for you is to tell us what you enjoyed about the course. So let's start with Mick. What did you enjoy?
I think the creative process as a whole, starting off with no idea what to do, coming up with an idea and then progressing it, planning it, and then maybe thinking, well, no, this isn't working, and going back again and reviewing, and then finally getting something that was worth constructing, especially in the assemblage, and I ended up with something that was a pleasing result.
Fantastic, yeah. And that's the artist's life. That's what it is. So well done. Thank you, Mick. Debra, what did you enjoy?
I loved working with the clay and learning to make the cast and the mould and the algae. 30 word, but I liked it. That was a dream come true for me, because I'd always wanted for about the last 30 years to learn how to, you know, make a cast. And also I really, really enjoyed being with the Bravo family as usual. Yous are all fantastic and great fun.
Lovely. Thank you, Debra. Julian, what did you enjoy?
I particularly enjoyed the working with the clay. I like the fact that you could, it seemed to be very therapeutic to me. It had me completely engrossed in what I was doing. And whereas before I would have intrusive thoughts, I would have anxiety. When I was working with the clay, I just was completely absorbed in it. And, you know, to the point where you would start in the morning and before you know it, the weekend had gone and you think, well, what have I been doing? And you realise that it's just held your focus so well that you're enjoying it so much that you're not thinking about anything else. And the time absolutely flies by. I particularly like working in fine, in the clay. We had some clay that sort of went off, the terracotta clay went dry and cracked. So we got some better clay that was reinforced with nylon, and working with that, I was able to sort of create really fine detail, which I particularly enjoyed doing. And I like to see sort of almost the picture you're trying to convey sort of coming up out of the clay as you sort of remove the clay around it. So it was really rewarding and I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Fantastic. It's interesting, isn't it, that you know, sculpture can be many things. It can be very big or it can be very fine. Fantastic. And Sarah, what did you enjoy?
I think it's been the whole processes from the start of starting the course thinking, yeah, I'm never going to be able to do this, to coming across the last project and thinking, yeah, I can really get into this. It's really helped my confidence. The sessions have been interesting and fun, and it comes down to you and the Bravo 2-2 guys. You've been awesome, Mick, get that word in. And you know, you created an extended family again, so thanking you.
Thank you, that's lovely. Thank you all very much, really, really lovely. Okay, so we're going to look now at our final sculpture. And this was based on a theme. This was the first piece that was a sort of a theme imposed by me. But it was very general. It was telling my story. That was our theme. And the participants could use any of the techniques and materials that we'd covered, or techniques and materials that they already knew about. It could be any of the systems that we'd used, and it could be anything about your personal story. So it could be something very fragmentary. It could be I feel great because the sun's shining. It could be just a fleeting thing, or it could have been I want to communicate how I feel after a year of COVID. It could be anything, but it was about communicating something about yourself to an audience. Now, because each of these pieces are very, very special and very particular to each of our members, we asked people to write a very brief statement about their work. So what we're going to see now is a film with the statements. So you will learn more about the thinking behind the piece. Let's have a look at that.
Thank you.
Wow. I hope there is not a dry eye in the house. They were just wonderful. Thank you so much, everyone. It's just been such a treat to work with you all, and the work is wonderful. You've all surpassed yourselves. So thank you.